The nature of discovery has changed and you need to change to keep up. Welcome back to the vlog. This is Every Day, and the nature of discovery has changed. What discovery used to mean in a sales perspective was that we're going to go in and we're going to discover what pain points that the client has. We're going to understand what their needs are. We're probably going to try to understand their buying process. We're going to discover all these things about the client so that we can put together some sort of solution for them and help them get the results that they're not getting right now. That's what it historically meant. And there's still some truth to that now. But discovery's changed quite a bit, and I want to just outline a couple of those changes because it means that we have to change what we do. The first thing that I'll tell you is that if your clients knew how to produce a better result, they'd already be producing that. And if your dream clients or your prospects were getting those results from your competitors, they wouldn't be dissatisfied and they wouldn't have any reason to change at all. And many of them think they don't have any reason to change at all. Many of them are happy with the status quo, or at least they're comfortable and they don't want to do anything to disrupt what's already the devil that they know. When we come in and we do discovery now, the first visit or the first couple visits for many of us is about helping the client discover something about themselves, something that lets them recognize they could be producing a better result than they are right now. That's the compelling case for change. That's the first shift in discovery. But discovery now covers so much territory because it's so difficult for a buyer to make a decision. And there's all these steps that I outlined in the Lost Art of Closing, the commitments that the client has to make to actually get a better result. First, they have to commit to exploring change at all. And then they have to decide whether or not that change is compelling enough for them to commit to taking all of the next steps. We call that the commitment to change, and it's probably one of the most difficult ones to get because we have to say something like, listen, if all these things are true, does it make sense for you to invest the time and the money and the resources in creating this kind of a change to acquire these better results we've been talking about? And you ask that early, because if you don't ask it, then later on you find out you've delivered a proposal and there's no will to really change. There's no commitment there. They also have to do this collaboration with us. They have to tailor it, and we have to have a lot of conversations about how we're going to make it work for that particular client or prospect. And then while they're still in discovery, they have to collaborate and get consensus within their own team. So they have to start taking the measure of every stakeholder and every group. Is this going to work for you? What do we need to change? And it's a difficult process. So what happens to us now is we become misaligned. We're here, they're here, or we're here, they're here. We're just not aligned anymore, and here's why. We've gone through our discovery phase, and we've checked all the boxes on our sales process. Do we know who the decision makers are? Yes. Do we have a clear understanding of their problem? Yes. Do they agree that it's a problem worth solving? Yes. We say yes to all these questions, and we think we're done, and we're ready to hand off that proposal. But on the client side, they still haven't collaborated internally around this. They still haven't had the internal conversation, does it make sense to change? Can we get the money? Are we going to be able to devote the resources? Are we going to be able to invest the time in this? They haven't built an internal consensus. They haven't agreed on what the right answer should be and that everyone wants to go along with it. And they maybe haven't acquired the money. Even though budget used to be the first thing that we look for, do you have budget? A lot of the things that we're proposing, there's no budget yet. The world of sales has changed dramatically. It's non-linear now. But what we need to do is make sure that we're lined up. If we're misaligned, we get back aligned and say, listen, they're not through discovery yet. So we got to pull them back down here and we got to stay in the discovery phase with them, or we got to help them do this. But you can't avoid these conversations now, and you can't believe that discovery is what it once was, because it isn't. It's changed. I'm Anthony Annarino. You can find me at thesalesblog.com. You found me here, youtube.com/Annarino. Hit the like button. Share this with somebody who's come misaligned or become misaligned in the sales process with a client that they're pursuing. And hit subscribe. This is Every Day.